Lord. So what are you saying, Bishop? I want to be able to tell you right now, when the devil is outside and you don't know what to do, I want to be able to say, you know what to do. All because you are in place the day that God taught you what to do when the devil appeared to be about to devour you. What do? You go where he can't come to. You go to God. You surrender unto this world. You give this world up. The only way you can go, as long as you remain and depending on something or somebody from this world, the devil can reach you. But when you surrender yourself, Lord, I surrender all. I give up this world. Ain't nobody but you and the devil that you can see. But the one that's going to save you is the one you can't see. So I surrender what I can see to go to where I can't see, because where I can't see, the devil can't come. So what God said, God will take me out of the reach of Satan even when I'm looking at it. This will take me out of the reach of Satan even when I'm looking. Lord, take me beyond so you know what to do. Just say, Lord, I surrender all. I surrender all. Lord, now let me teach them and show them how to get there. Not just get there, but to stay there. We thank you, Lord, for all things. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Wow. Out of the reach of Satan, that'll preach. Out of the reach of Satan. If you have your Bibles, I need you to... Wow. Tonight you're going to be on the right. Anybody got a paper? Remember, tonight you're going to look like on the right by the time you leave here. Wow. Thank you, Holy Ghost. If you have your Bibles, I need you to turn your Bibles to Romans 11:25-36. My wife, she just was looking so fabulous. I'm going to tell y'all something about my wife. We were coming to church and I had to go home and change clothes, and she was looking fabulous. And then I went in the room. I went in and came out, and I was all dressed up. And then she had changed clothes 2 months. She was already looking fabulous. We got home, and then when I walked out, she was looking more fabulous.
Always.
I said, "How you gonna go from fabulous to more fabulous? I just got dressed to catch up with you. You done left me again. I mean, every time I try to catch up with you, she leave me again. And she went from fabulous to more fabulous. Thank you, baby. Keeping me chasing that fabulous." Praise the Lord. The word of God, if you there, say amen.
Amen.
The word of God, Sister Cleo, she done got so caught up in the prayer, she just set the camera down. I'm going to pray for you, girl. I mean, she just all in the prayer. I'm like, I thought it would be a recording. Oh, I'm sorry. Woo, they wake up with Jesus, baby. We used the real thing tonight. See, y'all be all over the house when y'all be all waking with you. I be talking to y'all, don't nobody say that, because y'all be all in the other part of the house because I can't see you. Finally, what I'm saying, oh, bitch, you calling. Why do y'all say something? Because I can't get to the phone. It's the real thing tonight, baby. Keep the camera rolling. If you have Romans 11, say amen. The word of God reads, I want you to understand this mystery, dear brothers and sisters, so that you will not feel proud about yourselves. Some of the people of Israel have hard hearts. But this will only last until the full number of Gentiles come to Christ. And so all Israel will be saved, and the scriptures say, the one who rescues will come from Jerusalem. And he will turn away from ungodliness. And this is my covenant with them, that I will take their sins. I will take away their sins. I will take away their sins. Many people of Israel are now enemies of the good news. And this benefits you Gentiles. While they, the ones who are chosen, are rejecting, God said, while they're rejecting, I'll focus on those who don't know no better. So it benefited those who didn't know God when those who knew God wasn't doing what God wanted. He said, y'all said, y'all know that scripture that said you can't teach a dog new tricks. An old dog new tricks. What verse is that? But this is what God is saying. Why keep trying to deal with your hard-headed folks when if I would just offer to those sinners what I have given you, they would be grateful. They would be grateful. That's right. They would be grateful. See, y'all worried about if when y'all when we know we children of God, all we worried about is being, when we want to be grateful, we worried about being full of greatness. We're not concerned about being thankful for His grace. Children of God who think they're all that in a bag of chips, they want to be full of greatness. So when they say I'm grateful, they just saying I'm greater than you. But God said, I'm not dealing with no hard heads no more, because if I would give sinners what I have given you, they would be grateful.
Amen.
For the grace. Amen?
Amen?
So the word of God goes on and it says, and this is my covenant with them. I will take away their sins. The reason he take away the sins of what? All man what? All mankind. Why did he take away the sins of all mankind? Because he wanted all mankind to come to heaven. And he said, now there's no reason that you cannot come to heaven anymore, because I have taken away what was keeping you out of heaven. I'm going to take away your sins. Many of the people of Israel are now enemies of the good news, and this benefits the Gentiles, yet they are still the people he loves, because he chose their ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. For God's gifts and his call can never be withdrawn. Once God gives you something, he can't take it back. But he said, if you don't want it, I'll go work with somebody who want what I gave you. Hello? So he says, I can't take it back, but I will give it to someone who's going to be grateful. Grateful, G-R-A-T-E-F-U-L, and not worried about being greater than. And it goes on, and he says, once you Gentiles were rebels against God, but when the people of Israel rebelled against him, God was merciful to you instead. Now they are the rebels, and God's mercy comes to you so they too will share in God's mercy. For God has imprisoned, we're going to be reading tonight. God has imprisoned everyone in disobedience so that he can have mercy on everyone. So he have made all of us disobedient vessels. Oh, how great are God's riches and wisdom and knowledge. How impossible is it for us to understand his decision and his ways. For who can know the Lord's thoughts? Who knows enough to give him advice? Who has given him so much that he needs to pay it back? For everything comes from God, comes from him, exists by his power and is intended for his glory. All glory to him forever and ever. I want you to remember this. Keep that scripture in your spirit. Here I am, and God has made me understand who I am. No, he's not. He's making me understand the other folk. He's making the Gentiles understand why he's dealing with them, because of what the chosen ones, the Jews, are not doing. So God is no longer concerned about Gentiles and Jews. He's concerned about chosen and unchosen. So God said, now, those who are chosen are the ones who accept what I want to give them. Those who are unchosen are those who don't want to accept it. So God is letting us know how the chosen folk are rejecting. So God will say, I will create a new chosen folk. Y'all got that?
Yes, sir.
And I will create them from the place, and I will create them from the place that you don't expect them to come from, the world of sin. I'm going to get the Gentiles. So tonight, what we're talking about, tonight, the title of our sermon tonight, the prisoners are released. The prisoners are released. So now what I'm hearing,
yes, sir.
I'm hearing the ones who didn't know God, they were in prison because of lack of knowledge. God said, we are in prison because of disobedience. So those who are in prison because of lack of knowledge, God said, I'm going to free them by giving them the knowledge I gave you that you didn't appreciate.
My God.
I'm going to free them by giving you the knowledge that I gave the ones I chose. And then what's going to happen is the ones I chose are going to get jealous of the ones that they thought they were greater. The ones I chose are going to get jealous because they're going to be upset because I'm dealing with the ones that they thought they were greater than. Ooh, but y'all just stay here for this. Y'all be blessed tonight like you've never been blessed before. Now watch what he says. He says, oh, how great are God's riches and wisdom and knowledge. How impossible it is for us to understand his decision and his ways. But there is a place to understand God's decision. There's a place to understand God's way. God said, I will give my mysteries to those who love me. So if I want to understand God, all I got to do is fall in love with him and don't fall out of love.
Amen.
So God said, I will give my mysteries to those. He said, so if you want to understand me, fall in love with me and I will reveal to you what you need to know.
Glory to God.
Now, what is my biggest problem? My biggest problem ain't me. My biggest problem is you and how you affect me.
Come on, Bishop.
See, when you affect me, you make me not be me.
Come on, Bishop.
But when you affect me, I'm glad you affect me, because now when you affect me, I can blame you and not blame me. Wow. So I'm all messed up, because is it me or is it you? Or is it you or is it me? What is my biggest problem?
My God.
My biggest problem is not God. My biggest problem is not wanting the understanding that is available to me, and it comes from loving God.
Yes, sir.
That's my biggest problem.
Yes, sir.
Because when I get to understand that my biggest problem is not loving God, and I cannot step into the understanding that God wants me to have for him without loving him, I will reveal my mysteries unto those that love me. I'm Pastor, I need, wow, I got it. I got it. Y'all here with me? Y'all with me?
Yes, sir.
Who you with?
Oh.
All right. Now watch this. I'm going to Ephesians. I'm going to Ephesians 3. Just listen. I'm going to break this down and then we're going home. Because you're going to be free after I break this down.
Break it down here.
God did not reveal it to previous generations. Well, his mysteries. But now, by his spirit, he has revealed it to his holy apostles and prophets.
Yes, sir.
Those who is an apostle. Let's get that understood. Who is an apostle? We look at people who carry these titles. And they're not even apostolic unto themselves.
Uh-oh.
See, apostles are supposed to be one that build churches.
Yes, sir. That's right.
I can build a church with people, but I ain't yet been concerned enough to build a church with myself.
Come on, Bishop.
So God said, I will reveal this to those who are apostles and those who are prophetic. Now, you got to understand what a prophet does. We all get caught up with the prophet said, and the prophet said, and the prophet said. What did the prophet say? God bless you, Angel. Make sure you watch the sermon tomorrow. I'm going to give you a test on it for leaving early. All right. What did the prophet say? And the prophet said. And the prophet said. So I'm prophetic because the prophet said. So Jesus was a prophet. Paul was a prophet. Daniel, of course, was a prophet. Judas was a prophet. When Judas said, oh, please don't kill him because he has not done nothing wrong. God told him that. So the bottom line is, he says, I will reveal it to the holy apostles and the prophets. The prophets are anybody that hear from God.
Yes, sir.
Right now I'm being prophetic. Because I'm not speaking on my own knowledge and wisdom. I'm speaking according to what God has given me. Amen?
Amen.
So now as I hear this, it says, I will reveal it to the holy apostles and the prophets. He's talking about his mysteries. And this is God's plan. Watch this. Both Gentiles and Jews who believe in the good news shall share equally in the riches inherited by God's children. What is the riches inherited by God's children? Your house, your car, your husband, your church? No! Slow the camera down. The riches, the greatest riches that you have from God is the opportunity to live on earth. We're so caught in what we want beyond what we can't have, so we don't even appreciate the fact that without life, we wouldn't even have the opportunity to want what we don't have. So when God says we are all a part of one body, y'all don't get it? I told you last night. I said, if you don't think you got boundaries, leave this earth.
Come on now.
So the body that we are part of, and watch it now, watch it, because I'm going to lose you in a minute if you don't stay on this train. Don't you look out the window, because I'll pass you by. The body that we are a part of is the earth.
Yes.
We are all part of one body because we all came from the
earth.
Hello?
Come on,
hello? So the body that I need to be concerned at, that he said, you are a part of the body, and the body is not you. The body is not us being connected. We're already connected because we are dirt.
That's right.
So we already connected. The body that we need to be thankful for is the opportunity to walk around on dirt while I am yet dirt. Because without that, I wouldn't be able to think about the house. I wouldn't be able to think about the things of another world if I was not a part of first this world. Y'all better hear the word of God.
Yes, sir.
If I wouldn't be able to think about the things of another world, if I was not a part of this world. The body is the earth. God created the earth, then he made us a part of it.
Y'all better hear the word of God.
Yes, sir. Y'all better hear the word of God. So as long as you're desiring things beyond earth, you don't see a value what God has already done for you. The body is the earth. We're all a part of the earth. We're all a part of one body. But no, we can't be a part of one body because we want to be better. You don't get no better than life.
That's right. Come on, Bishop. Thank you, God.
Slow it down. I don't care how big your house is. Guess what? I don't care if you stay in Parkland and I stay over here in this neighborhood. We still inside this.
Come on, man.
I'm trying to free you tonight. I want the prisoners to be released. So the place that has you captive is the earth. Because I am trying to live beyond and appreciate. And there's nothing more than to appreciate the fact that God gave me life.
Yes, sir.
That's it. I am a part of. Y'all with me?
Yes.
Yes. Don't look out the window. I'm going to pass you by. Watch what he says. He said, and this is God's plan. Both the Gentiles and the Jews, those who live on the earth, are part of the earth. Both the Gentiles and the Jews who believe in the good news share equally in the riches inherited by God's children. The riches inherited by God's children is the wisdom of I appreciate being a part of the earth.
Amen.
I can't even think about heaven till I appreciate what God has already given me.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now watch what it says. It says, both are part of the same body. Both are part of the same earth. Ain't this real? Slow the camera down. I don't care if you black, white, purple. I don't care if you live in India, Canada, Europe. It don't matter. You still are part of this. Jesus, Bishop, you just lost your mind. I'm supposed to be peculiar to you, your carnal thinking. I'm supposed to be this way.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
Both are part of the same body, and both enjoy the promises a blessing because they belong to Christ Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Godly. So now, I am a slave, I'm a prisoner of Christ Jesus. Why are you a prisoner of Christ Jesus? Without him dying and being your savior, you wouldn't even be existing, right? God was getting, he was through with me. He said, I'm done with it. I go to Jupiter and start all over. He was through with man on earth. And Jesus said, let me go and show them. Ain't nobody really showed them, Daddy. You just threw them to the wolves. And Satan came down there. And Satan been having his way with them. You get Satan out the way and let me show them how to love you. In the body that they're in. We all want to come out of the way to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. God said, you ain't going to be present with me until you learn how to love me in the body. In the body. By God's grace and mighty power, I have been given the privilege of serving him by spreading the good news. And here it is. The good news. Come on this way, angel. The good news. You're about to find out tonight. Anybody want to know what the good news really, really is?
Yes, sir.
Anybody want to know what the mysteries of God really, really are?
Yes.
Stay tuned. Though I am the least deserving of God's people, you always hear me say, I'm the last one that should be doing this. If God had came in this church and said, who is worthy of being a bishop? I would have looked at everybody but myself. Who is worthy of being a pastor? I would have looked at everybody but myself. I would have recommended everybody but me because I knew me. And if you was honest about yourself and humble, you would have recommended everybody but who?
Yourself.
But some of y'all would have been raising your hand. Lord, here I am. I knew you were coming to get me. I knew. And God said, you are the very least. The ones that he said, those that feel like they're deserving are the most undeserving. And those that feel like they're undeserving are the most deserving.
My
God. Do you want to be free tonight?
Yes.
Because you truly are a prisoner of Jesus Christ. But Jesus didn't come he came to free you. He came to give you liberty. He says, though I am the least deserving of God's great people, he graciously gave. Okay, let's work on that word, grace. Our problem with is grace is we never say thank you. See, how you spell grateful is G-R-A-T-E-F-U-L. But a person that appreciates God's grace spells grateful, G-R-A, thank you, E-F-U-L. G-R-A, thank you, Janet, E-F-U-L. Someone who appreciates and values the grace of God. Instead of using a T, where the T is, they put thank you. So now I don't have the C, so now I value and I appreciate God's grace, so now I'm grateful. And I spell it G-R-A, thank you, E-F-U-L. You got that, mother? So as I do this and I'm hearing this, I know y'all said, Bishop, you watch how God tied this up. He gonna tie this together and go. It blew me away this morning. It blew me so far away I couldn't even stand the glory of God. I don't normally share what God gave me in a moment for a sermon, but I had to go get First Lady because I could not stand the glory of what God gave me in the moment this morning.
Hallelujah.
I couldn't stand it. And it will release you and it will free you. But you got to understand where understanding comes from. Somebody repeat after me.
Understanding
comes from God. And
how I get that understanding
is to love God.
More than anything. Or anybody.
Y'all got that?
Yes, sir.
So understanding comes from loving God.
Yes.
Repeat that.
Understanding
comes from loving God. Y'all got that?
Yes, sir.
It's important that you get that. Because I'm going to be through in a minute. But if you don't get that, you will not get what God is about to reveal to you. Understanding comes from loving God. I was chosen to explain to everyone the mysterious plan that God, the creator of all things, have kept secret from the beginning. Pastor Joyce, it knocked me down. Here we are running around, and God said, he always telling us, don't be what? Selfish. I remember Pastor Neeson preached an awesome sermon called Selfish or Selfless.
Yes.
And when I heard this morning, and I'm sitting here, God said, I will reveal my mysteries to those who love me. So if I'm in love with God, I'm walking in the assurance that I'm all right. You all right, man of God? Woman of God, you all right? Woman of God, you all right? Woman of God, you all right?
Yes.
Now my camera girl over here, I don't know. Woman of God, you all right? I'm walking in the assurance that I'm all right. How can I not walk in the assurance that I'm all right and love God more than anything? So that means if I love God more than anything, that means I trust him more than anything. So if I don't trust him more than anything, I don't love him more than anything. And if I'm still worrying, that means I'm lying about loving him, because if I'm worried, I don't trust him.
Come on now, Bishop. My God.
So I can't be worried. So if I really love God with all my heart and I'm trying to get understanding, I don't need understanding a man. Understanding a man made me think I was smarter than somebody else, and I always ended up looking like that donkey. Leaning on my understanding. Here you are. Can you help me? There was a time she couldn't help herself. So more than likely she can't help you. But she gonna act like she can. Y'all better learn. Y'all only going to people to get you out of trouble who know trouble better than you.
Amen.
Surrender to God.
Amen.
Fall in love with him. Surrender to God. He said, I will reveal my mystery to those who love me. And then right here he says, I was chosen. So now we just said, God is concerned about two people, the chosen ones and the unchosen ones. I say that tonight you are here because you were chosen.
Thank you.
You were chosen to fall in love with God because he wants to reveal his mysteries to you.
Thank you, God.
Man of God, softly, because I'm through.
Thank you.
You were chosen by God because he wants to reveal. Now, what kind of help? He wants to reveal his mysteries to you. I can't look at my brother or my sister and want to help my sister unless I check with God first. I can want to help her all I want. I can run over to her and she say, I need my light to pay. I can run over to her and I can give her the money to pay her light bill. But if I do it, she's going to be right back here next month. But if I go to God and I say, Lord, just like I trust you for me, I trust you, Lord, for her. God said, I want you to show her you got the life of your money. And then I want you to take it and put it in your pocket.
My God.
And then I want you to tell her what I tell you to tell her, because I know what she needs. It's not the light bill she needs. She needs a spiritual plan on how to spend God's money. God said, just tell her to tithe. And then when you tell her to tithe, if she look at you and say, I do it and her heart is sincere, when she get home, she gonna find money that she hid that she didn't know she hid. Keep her for not wanting no more. I will reveal my mysteries unto those that love me. So, for me to get an understanding of God, I've got to love him. God said, all you got to do, if you want to know anything, just love me. So now as I'm standing here, and the Lord told me this morning, the mystery of God is you. Your brothers and sisters. love me, I will trust her to you. I will tell you exactly what to tell her. And because she understands what I'm saying matches up with what I wrote in her heart, she will receive. All this time I've been reading, I will reveal my mysteries. I thought there was a certain way to love. I thought there was a certain way to do things. And God said the mystery is helping your sister when you, in a way that you don't know how. And the only answer is going to come from the one who created her, and he loved you. And he said if you love him, he will tell you what love can do for her. You are the mystery.
Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you.
This is my mystery. You are my mystery. And I got a God not for answers for me, but answers for
Holy Ghost.
I told you it was released tonight.
Yes.
There's no greater release than to learn the mysteries of God.
Yes, sir.
Answers. So y'all looked at me tonight when I was talking to Sister Loretta. He just talking. No, God was showing me. He let her moan. He let her weep because he was showing you that this man loves me, and I'm going to speak to the mystery. I'm going to tell her what she needs. Now, if she sees me as a vessel of God, she will. Did you receive that tonight, Sister Loretta? Did you receive that? Did you see? Did you watch it? I mean, you don't appease me. And don't. Did you accept the membership? Did you accept that tonight? Did you? Now here it is. Did you tell me what you wanted? Did you tell me why you was moaning? You didn't tell me, did you? But you know who told me? The one who was concerned about you being a mystery unto me. Now I'm going to hear the word of God. Where there's no understanding. Y'all hear me? I know last night you jumped and you shouted, but I didn't tell you you were going to jump and shout tonight. I told you you were going to be released from prison. And when you understand that you got the key to everything that everybody needs that God puts in your path, they are the mysteries. I will reveal her needs, his needs, her needs, her needs, his needs, his needs. Y'all don't even realize this.
Oh, wow.
Man of God, did God give me a mystery about you tonight? Huh? See that? Trust with his mysteries. I'm not a genie. I'm not a great speaker. I'm just somebody who loves God. And he said, those who love me, I will reveal my
word of God. We got a mystery, saints.
And when you come into that kind of knowledge, you walking in the assurance that God is taking care of you. And the part that he ain't taking care of, he got somebody who's going to take care of your weakness. Meaning what? Reveal what you need because of their love for him. You got that? Ain't that beautiful?
Yes, it is.
Isn't that beautiful?
How
tuned God is. He allowed the woman of God to just break down and moan. He cried out in need.
Holy Ghost, thank you.
And I could have let y'all touch, I could have let y'all pray for her, but the Lord told me to say, get away, because I got somebody who loves me, and I'm going to give him understanding of her needs.
Yeah. Come on, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Yes, God. You are the mystery. I will reveal
her brokenness. And God said, the only reason I'm going to reveal it to you, because you love me And I am going to send you the power to heal.
Yes, sir. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Y'all get ready in this church to what? Y'all get ready. It won't be long. Y'all say, who did wrong? What did one man name? The one who want to beat up everybody. No. Sister Keisha, little boy.
BJ.
God said, I sent BJ over there to show you. I'm going to show you through BJ, Spirit of Jesus. But see, don't you go to looking at BJ. When it's going to happen, it's just like watching the clock. Long as you watching the clock, it ain't going to move. But BJ is our mystery. And God said, you keep loving me, and I will give you the answers that the doctors don't even have.
That's right. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, Holy Ghost. Come on.
I will give you the answers about BJ that the doctors don't even. He is our mystery. And he said, those kind of breakthroughs come through attaching yourself and praying with God at all times, fasting and
praying.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
See, when you got to understand that word fasting, it ain't talking about starving yourself. It's talking about lifting up Jesus and don't let him go. Fast him.
Come on, Dante.
See, when I fast, y'all might fast and starve yourself. When I fast, I fasten myself to Jesus. I fasten myself to the deliverer. I fasten myself to the healer. I fasten myself. See, when y'all fast, see, so now as I'm fasting, I'm praying, I'm telling, come on, man, you let me go over here and show you. I know I love God, but he ain't told me how to deal with this mystery. He ain't told me how to deal with this mystery. So when I fasten myself to Jesus, guess what? God said, wherever two and three come together, touching, come on, fasting themselves, touching them. Bishop, you done reached too far. It ain't never too far for God.
That's right.
He has sent her to a place where we understand loving God. He will give us a plan and the words to change with God. And he gave him ears. He gave him a mouth. He said, but I just need somebody to touch him. Somebody. So here I am. Am I going to be the one? Am I going to be the one? No, the body of the Spirit of Jesus is going to be the one.
The body of the Spirit of Jesus.
The body of the Spirit of Jesus.
Yes.
Going to come. We're going to fasten ourselves together.
Yes.
And we're going to, God said, if this is what it takes for you to become a church without spot and blemish, for this young man to be able to hear, either get with it or leave.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And I'm going to tell everybody. Because I don't need no hindrance to the move of God.
Okay.
I want y'all to know that this ain't no play. Ain't nothing to play with. I want you to know that God is real.
Yes.
Y'all didn't hear what Elijah told him. Elijah said, I'll burn that altar up. And they said, you can't burn it up, man of God. And they said, Elijah told him, go get some buckets of water. Get some buckets of water and throw on it. Go sit down. You sit down. Get some buckets of water and throw on the altar. He said, soak it down with water. And we know anything wet don't burn. Anything faithless don't heal like we need a healing for BJ.
Amen.
Anything faithless don't heal cannot give the kind of healing that BJ needs. And if that's what it takes for us to become a 100% tithing church, 100% attendance church, we're going to see if you just talk love or do you love for real.
All right.
And all you talkers, adios. I ain't going to move you. I ain't going to kick you out. God going to shut the door on you. Because you know what? BJ going to be healed with or without you.
Amen.
And I promise you, when I can heal him now, man of God, I can hear him now. BJ gonna come in the church talking and laughing and grinning. Say, I know what y'all were saying all the time. I knew it. And I can hear y'all top this liars.
Ooh, Jesus.
Y'all know top this liars. Oh yeah, it was a little boy at our church. Now you wasn't even coming to church. You wouldn't even be a part of the miracle.
Uh-oh.
We just asked you to help the miracle. And I can hear you now. It's a little boy at our church. You wasn't even there. You saw it on Facebook. But I was at the church, and he came in. This little boy ain't never talked like her, but he came in the church. There you go. You was not even. And God ain't going to let that lying spirit come back up in here. I want us to go on a mission, and I don't care if it take God 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, we gonna believe this by faith, all right?
Amen. Yes.
Ain't y'all ready to be different from the church across the street?
Yeah.
Ain't you ready to be different from the church down the street? So not different to be different, but different to show them that God is yet living and he's still in the healing business.
Yes.
Ain't y'all ready?
Yes, sir.
Ready.
Elevation.
I'm telling you something, you know the miracle I gotta do? This church won't be able to hold the people.
Amen.
You hear me?
Yes.
That's our miracle. That's how we're going to build ourselves. That's how we, BJ, is the way we're going to get our compound on 31st and Oakland Park.
That's, right.
That's our property.
Amen.
And BJ is the key.
Amen.
When BJ get healed and the people hear that a child that was deaf and mute is now talking and hearing, ain't gonna come to your church. But God says it's gonna take dedication like I ain't never seen at the church.
Amen.
And if you can't dedicate yourself, I mean, I love you. But I can love you and not feed you. I promise you.
Yes, sir.
I can love you and not feed you.
Yes, sir.
And if it means not feeding you for BJ, huh? Go and eat some brown grass.
Yes, sir.
I can love you and not feed you.
Yes, sir.
But I want to see BJ. And God done told me. Y'all hear what he said tonight?
Yes.
God said, if you love me, I will give you understanding of what he needs. And I showed you through the woman of God tonight. I will give you understanding. He is our mystery. Given unto us by who? He's our blessing. When people hear that he was deaf and mute, and now he's talking because God gave us understanding of what to do and say. And, well, Bishop said that one night, I've been going to church for a whole 2 months. You can knock if you want to.
Oh, my Lord.
But I won't be there to talk. And I want him to hear. And God has shown me that he can hear. We were back there one day, and I said, BJ, you need to stop that right now. He looked at me. Brother, said, did you see that? Brother, said, did you see that? I thought, because I wasn't going to say nothing, but she saw it. Didn't you see it, brother? See, but he got on him exposed to nobody in here talking about top that line. Need no top. He ain't gonna hear nobody in this church that's representing top that line. Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
He got virgin ears, and when he walk in here with his virgin ears, he gonna hear the Holy Spirit, and it's all gonna ring in his ears for the rest of his life.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And he's going to build our sanctuary on Oakland Park in 31st. Y'all see, y'all know where the bazaar used to be?
Yes.
Amen. That's ours.
Amen.
That whole, that's going to be our compound.
Yes.
Have a family center there. And then we're going to move all them people out of the Somerset and clean that up. We're going to get all those spirits out of there. We're going to own that too.
Amen.
How do I know? Because when there were condos, I used to live there, and I told God I wanted them back. Y'all hear me?
Yes.
I'm just that crazy. Y'all, I'm tired of. No longer shall I let the people lead my thinking. I shall think as God has always led me to think, beyond where I am, not beneath where I am. So y'all come on and go with me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are the mystery. So now, I need to love God, not for myself, but so he can tell me what I need to do to help you. And when I do that, I have been released from where? Prison.
Yes, yes, yes.
When I do that, I have been released from prison. What greater love than to know the mysteries of God, to know his people. Ain't that something?
Yes, sir.
This woman of God said, if it was in him, she said, Bishop, I ain't never seen nothing like you. You don't know how many times I was ghost. She said, I was out of there. She said, but I've seen God work through you like I've never. Have you, what you told me? Huh? She said, I ain't never seen nothing like it. Nothing like it. I have not either. But because she stayed, it showed that God gave her something that kept me. You understand? Because she's here. Something that kept me. Because you're here. So God said, if I can do that for Bishop, why can't we love BJ like that? If I can do that for Bishop, why can't we love BJ like that? I showed you what I can do. I ain't supposed to be standing here, let alone talking about giving somebody the mysteries of God. Tell me when you heard a word like this. You don't. You want to jump up and down, grab the ear, sound like a preacher. Preachers leave something that changes people.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Amen. 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 Everybody good?
Oh,
everybody good?
Hallelujah.
Everybody good?
Glory be to God.
Everybody good?
Hallelujah.
We need to do it for BJ. So we gonna bring BJ up Sunday. Y'all, I know you gotta go, man. God, I know you ain't gotta go. We're gonna bring BJ up Sunday. We're gonna bring BJ up Sunday. And we are going to make a declaration unto the God as a church. So you call all the members and tell them to be here Sunday. Tell them to be here Sunday. And BJ is gonna be the key to our compound. Y'all hear me?
Yes.
He's gonna be the key. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. How many people think? prison tonight. See, now, y'all know, Bishop don't, Bishop, I'm not.